As we head toward the elections, we're already in the primaries, as we head through the elections, toward the nomination and the final election or re-election, as the case may be, I am reminded, as I am reading, of the war between the Greek city-states and the Persian Empire. I'm reminded of our modern-day republic and its democratic principles. And I read this from ancient Athens. After the Battle of Marathon, circumstances conspired to render the political life of Athens very lively indeed. Class interests, part complementary and part conflicting, between sections of the increasing voting public, great and small landowners and farmers, great and small traders and merchants, skippers, sailors, and many self-employed craftsmen, formed the basis for later what we can recognize without difficulty as the politics of a democratic state. The new voters lacked confidence in themselves at first, and indeed, even in the golden age of the next century, they continued to mostly listen to aristocratic leaders, men who had learned politics from the conversations of their fathers and their fathers' friends, from boyhood onwards. At first, the result was that the ancient rivalry for power between the leading families was transformed into a struggle to win the votes of the popular people in the assembly. Gradually, in this process, the aristocratic leaders themselves began more and more to think like parliamentarians and less like tyrants. New leaders appeared who, although they had influential connections, they were represented as owing their position to the confidence of the ordinary voters. These men outlive in political struggles the old-style aristocratic politicians. It's quite amazing, you know, when you think that we have come so far and yet we're still fighting the same political struggles. And that is part of what fascinates me, is our nation is in this struggle to the end.